Hi, my name is Hinkit. I'm from Lee Restaurant and Provisions, a newly opened bakery in Damansara Jaya. For today, I'll be showing you a very simple dish that I used to cook on my day off. It's basically a simple spaghetti with a cherry tomato sauce. Basically, what we'll do is we'll just chop it up. I love garlic, so I would actually put a little bit more garlic in it. Pick some really good ripe ones and just sort of slice it into halves. I don't usually like to slice it up, I like to just sort of pluck it up. First of all, we'll just put some salt. So season your water liberally. This pasta is, the packaging says 9 minutes, so I'll do it at about 8 minutes. No olive oil necessary, just making sure it doesn't stick to the sides or the bottom. Here you have about 5 to 6 cloves of garlic. Just want to sort of brown it up a little bit. Let the oil absorb the garlic. It's turning into this light brown, you want to make sure you turn it down. Then you get your tomatoes in. I would say maybe 15 to 20. Get a bit of salt, just season the tomatoes. As you season, the tip is to season your tomatoes so that the water will come out, the juices will come out, the cherry tomatoes. You can use a ladle, but I'm just going to sort of pour a little bit in here. Just be careful with this. Squish some of the cherry tomatoes to get the juices out. Just a little bit of pepper. All this is to taste. Just to keep the pasta water, just in case you want to add a little bit more liquid to the sauce. Straight away put it in the sauce right now. So sort of just let it simmer a little. Sort of give it a stir. And salt. And it's optional at this point, but if you want, you can add a little bit of chili flakes. So when you add Parmesan to a pasta dish, you want to make sure the heat is off so that it doesn't clump up, so it emulsifies with the pasta. So we'll just finish up the dish here in the bowl. The portions that I did here for today, it's enough for maybe 2 to 3 people. Serve it up in 2 different bowls. Just get a bit of the cherry tomatoes. So just sort of tear it up and just put it on top. So again, after the basil, we just want to finish off a bit of Parmesan as well.